morning. Up next here on Proactive London Today, discussing the progress of the US economic recovery and what this means for the reflation trade, as well as three investment themes to consider in this environment. It's the Fixed Income Investment Director, Anna Gill from F&G.
Rising bond yields, steeper curves, and soaring inflation expectations have gripped fixed income markets for much of the last few months. However, reflation-driven action seems to have lost some momentum in recent weeks. New waves in COVID infections, new lockdowns, and some doubts around the sustainability of inflationary forces have made investors wonder whether the reflation trend has run out of steam or whether it's just taking a breather. In this video, we'll explore the progress of the US economic recovery, what this means for the reflation trend, and some investment themes that are worth considering in such an environment. Growth in the US, measured by the ISM surveys, has hit the highest point in decades, both in the manufacturing industry, but also in the harder hit services sector. Retail sales, too, have been exceptionally strong recently, as the US consumer has finally begun to spend a lot of the savings that were put aside last year. With a tightening labor market, economists now predict US growth this year will be the best in nearly four decades. On the inflation side, things are very much alive too. The US CPI index beat expectations in March, rising to its highest level in years as the end of the lockdown has triggered a rebound in travel, leisure, and commuting. As we look ahead, we believe the string of solid economic data, combined with tightening in inflationary pressures, ongoing fiscal stimulus, and a cautious Fed, is all conducive for the reflation trend to resume. As a result, we would expect to see sovereign curves steepen further. From a fixed income perspective, three themes are worth considering when positioning for a reflationary environment. First of all, focus on yield without duration. As yields continue to rise, investors will want to focus on short duration or floating rate instruments, which can minimize interest rate risk whilst reducing bond price volatility. For example, high yield floating rate notes can offer investors an appealing level of income in today's low rate, low yield environment. And because they have close to zero duration, they are largely insulated from the negative effect that rising yields can have on bond prices. The resilience of the asset class was proven through the first quarter of 2021 amid the sell-off in global bond markets. High yield FRNs provided a buffer versus rising yields, delivering a strong returns. A second key theme in a reflationary portfolio is inflation protection. Here, inflation-linked bonds will provide the most conventional hedge versus inflation, with coupons that are automatically adjusted in line with an inflation index. And while inflation expectations have also repriced this year, it is still possible to capture relative value opportunities in areas where inflationary forces may appear less imminent. Finally, allocating to parts of the market that are expected to perform well in an economic recovery is another way to position for reflation. For example, investing in sectors that can benefit from the end of lockdown restrictions, such as transport, travel, or hospitality. Furthermore, capitalizing on credit research expertise can help identify alpha opportunities, such as potential rising stars. That is, companies that are likely to be upgraded from high yield to investment grade as a result of improved economic fundamentals. In summary, positioning for a post-pandemic world can present challenges for investors, but it can equally present opportunities. We believe an active approach is best placed to find relative value opportunities that are likely to arise as we move forward in 2021. Thank you for watching.